Hello and welcome to the 2019 Music City Open presented by Dynamic Discs. My name is Missy Gannon.
And I'm Haley King. I'm sponsored by Discraft.
And I'm sponsored by Dynamic Discs. We are bringing you round three coverage of the front nine. We hope you enjoy. This is a really, really long course, and it's definitely suited for some big arms, so you're in for a treat. This is hole one. It's a par four, 655 feet. You want to kind of get over this this hill here. This was an old ball golf course, and so it's really nice and maintained. The crew does a really good job out here. And yeah, you want to get over this hill. They're kind of showing you the left route right now where the camera is going. Some people like to turn it over and sort of be more on the right side, and then you have to navigate a little bit more of the trees, but it definitely cuts off some of the distance.
This is the 8:36 a.m. starting time. On the tee, Katrina Allen.
So Kat is in the lead. She is 12 under.
Yeah, she is killing it all weekend. This is definitely, like I said, a big arm course. There's definitely a lot of holes that we can all score on, but the back nine especially definitely caters to having a longer arm. So we're all sort of just playing for second and third at this point.
Yeah.
Kat goes really big on this hole. She tries to chop off a lot of distance. That's a little bit more on the right side.
On the tee, Missy Gannon.
There's Missy. She's one under.
Yeah, like I said, I'm trying to maintain second place at this point. And it's still a tight battle. I'm also trying to just throw a turnover. This is my Fusion Burst Trespass. I'm just trying to get as far down there as possible and staying a little bit more on the right side. You can sometimes hit a big hyzer over the trees if you're in a good position. So yeah, I'm just there a little bit shorter than Kat.
Lisa is plus one going into this round.
Yeah, her and Erica are pretty close in score right now, and obviously they're not too far behind me. So we're really all just trying to get that podium finish. Lisa's also trying to go big here. She's going off to the right a little bit more. She has a really good forehand, so that actually plays really well for her. If she's a little bit actually more on the left side, then she can throw a forehand up to the basket.
Erica is plus three going into this round.
Yeah, I think she might be throwing, I can't remember if it's a Destiny, something also slightly understable. Again, just trying to get as much distance off the tee. This is where you're gonna try to set yourself up in position. She turns it over a little bit too much, but she actually fights through really well and gets really far down the fairway. So she's gonna be looking at a similar shot to Kat and I, but she actually got a little bit further than us. So here's Lisa lining up that forehand, like I said. Definitely works really well for her. She turns it over a little bit too much, but she's pretty well out in the open over there. Those bushes aren't too bad.
Erica takes the hyzer gap, puts it right next to the basket. She'll have an easy putt for three.
She was set up super nice. That gap was right in her range right there. I was a little bit too far left. I actually usually take the big spike hyzer over the trees on the right side, but I decided to try up the gut and it didn't quite work out. Here's the line I was just mentioning. Kat's going over the top. She clipped some stuff early and ends up falling a little bit short, but we should all be able to get up and down pretty easily with Erica right there for the birdie. This is just a little chip shot. This is my tournament burst harp. Just trying to get my four and move on. Yeah, at least it was in the little bushes right there, but we found it pretty quickly. Looks like a little Nova turnover.
She's so good at that shot. When she throws a Nova, you know it's going to be close.
Yep, easy chip shot. We really are looking to get the three on this. It's not necessarily a must get, but it feels really good to start off on this really long hole and get the birdie. So let's see if Erica can capitalize. Yep. Great way to start, especially since she's just a few strokes behind Lisa and even myself. Definitely feels good to start that way.
Yep, good putt.
Yep, same for Kat, walking off with a par. And I'll be just dropping in for my par as well.
Hole 2 is 345 feet. It's a par 3 and it plays like an island. There's OB all around it, and if you don't make the island, I believe there's a drop zone off to the right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it plays quite a bit shorter. It's pretty downhill. You're sort of just trying to, you can either hyzer in with a nice soft hyzer into this gap and hopefully skip up there. Also, I've seen some forehands.
Yeah, forehands a nice route. I usually take a putter straight down the gap.
Mm-hmm. Erica's taking sort of that low line hyzer, trying to squeak through these trees. That's the only thing with that route, is you're sort of just trying to not hit those trees, and it's sometimes easier said than done. I believe Kat was taking a putter as well. I think all three rounds she took a putter and kind of came up a little bit short. I'm actually throwing a Fusion Burst Felon. I throw it nice out wide. It usually gets a good skip, and that's just around circle's edge, just inside. Lisa hangs it a little high, asking for it to get down, but unfortunately it goes OB.
Lisa with that Nova.
Yep. Yeah, she was pretty quick with that one. I don't think she was pretty happy with going OB on this hole. Yeah, Kat giving it a soft bid. Yeah. We won't talk about that one.
Erica with a nice birdie putt.
Yeah, that's a great start. Going birdie-birdie on hole 1 and 2 is just, you really can't ask for anything more. And actually, I think that ends up, at the moment tying up Lisa and Erica. And with that putt, that was unfortunately a bogey, so Erica will take solo third at the moment. Good par from Kat, and I will be taking the same. This one is certainly one that you want to get. I think we're all calling it a must get for sure. Hole 3, par 4, 634 feet. I would say it's a pretty soft par 4. I think a lot of us, it's not out of our range at all to get up and down for 3. You can sort of take this like inside hyzery gap on a backhand. You might be able to pump a big forehand out there as well. Yeah, you just have OB to the right is that cart path and beyond, I think. And then also there's a cart path way to the left, which shouldn't really come into play.
The goal on this hole is to just not be behind those big trees.
Yes. Yeah, you're sort of, at least for me, I was aiming for those trees in the middle and hoping to hyzer out before then. Kat's trying to go big. She turns it over a little bit, but she ends up on the right side of those trees, which is also pretty easy up and down.
Yeah, I think the shot is to just play a hyzer at that tree.
Yeah. I was aiming for the trees to try to hyzer before them, and I kind of forgot that there's actually a gap between those trees. I thought I was well in those trees, and luckily I got a little lucky. This is more the route that I was thinking of. Lisa just hyzering out just before the trees, and now she'll have a pretty open approach to the basket.
Erica has a very nice upshot. That should be an easy 3 for her.
Mm-hmm. I was a little bit of obstructed by low ceiling, but I just threw my soft deputy out there, and
it was a great shot.
Thank you.
Yep, right there.
Yeah, and here's the other side of the trees. A little bit more obstructed, but yeah. Nice forehand up to the basket. Yeah, easy 3 for Lisa. That feels good. A little left side. Yeah, those are some tough putts. Great. That's a turkey for Erica. You really can't ask for a better start than that.
When you birdie the first 3 holes, you're like, dang, okay.
Yeah. Yeah, Erica, I remember, definitely came to play today.
Hole 4 is 686 feet. It's a par 5. The tee shot is a little tight. I usually like to throw a little hyzer flip through that right gap there and just let it sit in the middle of the opening. If you get a kick off one of the first trees, it gets pretty brutal and you will be scrambling to meet par.
Yeah, if you can get out into the sunny area, then you are doing great, but it's still a huge dogleg to the right, and it takes still quite a bit of power. It's uphill. You want to turn it over. There's OB to that left side. You see those little white flags there? That's OB, so you really don't want to have anything hyzer out, but you also don't want to turn something over too much. But first thing is trying to get through this gap.
Thank you. Yeah, Erica had a nice shot. She's a little off on the left side, but should leave her pretty open for an up.
Yeah. I unfortunately pull it over a little bit too much. This tee pad was interesting. It was sort of downhill, and that sometimes makes you pull things over, just like Lisa did as well.
She got lucky.
Yeah.
That was good.
Yeah, she's in that ravine. There's a little ravine halfway down the fairway, but she should be able to at least get out into the open.
Kat looks like she pures it.
Yeah,
that's a great drive.
Crushed this shot. If you have a shot like that, it feels like a soft par five, but if you're like the rest of us, or at least me and Lisa, you feel a little bit thankful that you have a few more strokes that you can throw up to the basket. As you can see, I'm already throwing my third shot, so I'm just hoping to save par at this point.
That's out there. You should have a look at the basket.
Yeah.
I think Lisa's doing a flex forehand.
Yeah, she's actually, it's hard to tell from this angle, she's quite a bit pinched behind that tree that's right in front of her. So she first has to try to ante it around it and then hopefully get some fade back. But also be long enough that she's not at the corner on the right side.
It's a pretty tough shot from there.
Yeah, so
she
that's
gets on it a bit, but
yeah, that's the corner I sort of was mentioning. She's still going to be pinched, and she's going to have to throw some sort of big ante or forehand from there.
Yep, it's a pretty easy shot.
Yeah, that's
right
a,
in the middle.
That was great. She should be able to have a look at birdie.
Kat can't see the basket right now, but her disc knows where to go.
Oh, yeah. That was a great shot. She's already up there for an eagle look.
That's crazy. Mm-hmm.
So I'm just trying to put this close. It's my fourth shot, and I just need to have a putt. I'm throwing, I think, a mid-range. It's my gold line fuse. And unfortunately, I come up quite a bit short. I am in circle two, almost at circle two's edge. So, yeah. I'm still hopeful, but let me see.
Yeah, Lisa went into the woods a little bit. Looks like she's got a rough stance.
Yeah, she's still quite a bit from the basket right now, so having to throw a standstill does not help.
A little patent pending. Mm-hmm. Highs it out a bit, but she can see the basket now.
Yeah. Great shot. That was Erica's third shot, so she'll be dropping in for a birdie.
That was great. Her forehand's really developed a lot.
Yeah.
Lisa with the Nova again.
Mm-hmm.
I mean,
so like I said, I'm well into circle two and hoping to save that par.
Woo! Okay. That's why she's a putting world champion.
I just remembered, too, as we were getting up to this shot, that I had canned that one, so it felt really good. I hoped it was for birdie, but unfortunately, you know, at least I...
It's a good par save.
Yeah, at least I didn't lose any strokes on my score, at least.
Meanwhile, Kat's putting for an eagle.
Yes, I certainly lost strokes to Kat.
That's so crazy, though.
Yeah, that was a great hole for her.
She just made it look so easy. And then Lisa and Erica would be tapping out for...
I think Lisa got a par.
And then Erica par as well.
I think Erica got a birdie. I think she got up and down in four. So that was... That is four birdies in a row for Lisa. Hole five, another par four. I don't know if you've noticed, but there's been, I think about four of the last five holes have been over 600 feet. So, like I said, it's a really long course. I think it is the longest course in PDGA
maybe history. It would make sense.
Yeah, I think that's what they're saying. So yeah, this is, the tee shot's just something that you kind of need to just saw off a hyzer and get far, but also as left as possible would be helpful for your next shot. So we're just trying to shoot out this sort of like a gap from the woods out into the open.
It is an uphill tee pad, and when I was throwing this shot, I was like, no matter how much hyzer you put it on, you're going to be right in the middle.
Yeah. I always tried to change it up a little bit and saw it off. It's really hard to kind of tell yourself to saw off a backhand sometimes, especially when there's trees
right
on
there.
The left.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's definitely a tougher tee shot than you think. Yeah, right away I was just like, oh, well, that's going to be straight and left, which is not what you want, really, so, to the right.
All it does, really, is just make the upshot 20 feet longer.
Yeah, and it sort of makes it, there's OB all along the right side, and so you want to try to get as far up the hill as possible. I'm personally playing it for four. I don't know that I really could ever get there in three. Unless I make another big circle two putt like I did on the last hole, but even then, I'm just trying to avoid OB and get up and down for my par.
Yep, that's a great shot.
Yep.
Just hyzering out a bit, staying away from that OB.
I'm trying to turn this over. I don't quite do it. It's quite a bit uphill, but that's right up in the open. I should be fine.
Yep, it's up there.
Yeah, we're all sort of hanging out right up there right now. Kat's definitely trying to get close to the basket, and she's one of the few that can do that.
She's trying to get the birdie. I mean, it's easily possible.
Mm-hmm. She's almost pin high, if I remember correctly. But yeah. Going to give her a circle two putt downhill. Kind of scary. We've seen some rollaways on this hole.
Erica is just laying up for the par.
Yeah. Same for me.
Looks like she's getting a little half bit at it.
Yeah, I think Lisa definitely tries to throw a few in sometimes. She at least looks like she's going for it.
Yeah. Kat's putting for birdie right now. Yeah, it looks like she's like 5 feet outside of circle one.
Yeah, man, she was just a little low.
Erica had a great putt for par.
Yeah, actually a little shorter than I thought she was, but she jammed that all day. Great par putt for Lisa.
Yep.
Yeah, no problems with pars on this hole.
Hole 6 is 332 feet. It's a par 3. There's OB along the right side, and it kind of gets in the way because if you're trying to throw a backhand and you do a little hyzer flip and it turns over just the slightest bit, you're going to be going OB. I've seen plenty of people do it, but I think if you just hyzer out, you should be good.
Yeah, and we kind of just flew by the really large branch that sort of hangs low right before the basket. And that's sort of the one thing that you're trying to navigate if you're going straight at the basket. Let's see what Kat does. She tries to go for this sort of squeaky little slight hyzer. Looks like she throws it a little low, but she actually, I think first or second round, went just above that branch and just parked it.
Yep. That's the only branch that's really in the way.
Mm-hmm.
Erica's hyzering out. There's no problem with that.
Yeah, no danger over there. She'll have a long jump putt for her, too. I'm trying to go straight at it. My fairway driver just turned over a little bit too much, and yeah, unfortunately, I went OB.
I feel like it's really easy to go OB on this hole.
Yeah. Because you really have to commit to that shot. And if I had just put a little bit more hyzer on my drive, I think it would have been great. But
yep.
Yep, Lisa's sort of playing the same play as Erica on this hole.
She's got a long bid.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I totally forgot about that. That was a great putt.
That's pretty far.
Yeah. I mean, it wasn't even really a putt. It was, you know, she was trying to throw it, get it in or get it close. And
Yeah. Okay.
It worked out.
Cat doing cat things.
Yep. I'm lining up my OB. Womp womp. I still have a chance to save this. It's a little low ceiling, but...
That was hard with the low ceiling.
Yeah, the worst you want to do is like hit the first branch and snuck straight down.
Right.
So.
Erica has a long jumper.
Yep.
Looks like she just laid it up.
Yep. Erica knows she's sitting pretty good right now, and the front nine is certainly more scoreable. I remember this. we thought she saw like a snake or something, but she picked up her disc. And she saw two little baby birds sitting right underneath her disc.
Oh, wow.
The night before, we had this huge thunderstorm that lasted for a while, and we're thinking maybe they got knocked out of the tree that night. I don't know, but they seemed okay, and we're just hoping that the mama bird found them. But,
hopefully, yeah.
I mean, whoever expects to see two baby birds underneath or near their disc?
I've seen them on baskets before, but not underneath a disc. That's crazy.
So we obviously don't want to touch them because, you know. We don't want to cause any problems. So Lisa's trying to figure out, like, how can she still stand there while, you know, not disturbing them. So luckily she was able to figure it out. Yeah. There were some birdie puns happening at that point. So I got a bogey on this hole. You know, it is what it is. Good par from Erica.
So many birdie jokes.
par for Lisa. So hole 7 is a 587-foot par 4. It's sort of like, there's a couple different ways to attack this hole, but typically you're going to just try to bomb a long drive and try to get as close to the end of this fairway as you can. And then it swings to the left a little bit and up the hill. And so it's right behind those last three trees in the background there. So that's sort of the main play. I was actually trying to play with the early hyzer and sort of get to the left of those first row of trees and then have more of a straight shot up to the basket. It just caters to my distance a little bit better, but Kat's definitely trying to bite off a lot on this drive and get all the way to the end of the first fairway.
Yep, she crushed it. Pretty easy from there.
Yeah, I think that stake might be 250. I can't quite remember, but yeah, she's pretty close. Erica also just trying to bite off as much distance as possible. She might be a little pinched. She may also be able to go the inside route that I was mentioning earlier, but we'll see.
Yep. Lisa looks like she threw a good shot. She should have a hyzer from there. Mm-hmm.
And it looks like this round, I decided to just play the straight route. The other route was working for the most part, but I still never really had a chance at a birdie, so I figured I'd try something else out. But yeah, here's the inside route that Erica's taking. There's really no danger from this point on, so she's just trying to crush one up there and hopefully have an opening between those trees for a putt.
I think this hyzer row can be a little difficult because of the low-hanging branches right there.
Yeah.
But as long as you get around them or underneath them, it should put you up close to the basket.
Yeah. Yeah, similar shot to me. We'll have little jump putts at the basket. We'll have to navigate some trees, but yeah, this is actually the only round I think that Kat hit those early trees. Otherwise, she was throwing great shots just like that around the trees and pretty much parked every time. So still should be an easy up and down for a par, if not a birdie.
Yep. Erica looks like she just has that one big tree in the way.
Mm-hmm.
She can still give it a good bit, though.
Looks like she was.
Lisa with...
Yeah, this is sort of a tweener for me. Sometimes I jump putt, sometimes I don't, and I pulled it a little bit, but it's fine. Easy par for Lisa.
Erica Erica with the easy par as well.
And then, yeah, Kat and I will just be dropping in for our pars.
Hole 8 is 610 feet. It's a par 4. There's two routes you can take here. You can go on the left or the right. The only thing you have to worry about is that there are two paths on the left and right that both play as OB. And it's actually kind of like, it's really not that hard to go OB. But if one gets out of control, it's easily doable. You can hit one of those trees and just roll OB.
Yeah, and it's kind of hard to commit to. I think most of the people that I saw throwing went the right side, sort of play that hyzer back into the fairway. And yeah, you definitely saw some. You could even just throw a perfect shot but hit the base of a tree and then just roll straight OB. So it's hard to commit to that shot for sure. It's a little daunting. Luckily, I think the wind was down. It was just super hot and humid.
Yeah. I think the hyzer out is definitely the play because it does come back into safe, but...
Yeah. Yeah, Kat got way down there. Yeah. We're typically, like, just hoping to be near or past that last tree, and she just blew straight by that. Mm. Yeah. Unfortunately, she's right at the base of the tree, which... will make her next shot a little trickier, but she's at least in bounds.
Yep, in bounds as well.
Yep. Yeah, and fortunately I got a nice little skip past that tree. So.
It's a tough upshot from here because if you go a little long, there is the path that runs behind the basket. It's probably like 60 feet behind the basket.
Yeah, something like that.
But it drops off after the basket. So it's if you're flying past the basket, chances are you're going OB. So
yeah, this basket sits right on the edge of that little plateau right there. So, you know, you kind of have to land a perfect soft hyzer just like
that.
Lisa did. And yeah, and then if you're a little short, you know, that's sort of a death putt. So you just have to be really confident on the screen.
The rollaways are easy on this hole. They happen a lot. I know it happened to Callie and I on the same round.
Oh, no. Yeah, and like I saw right there, Erica just super pinched that tree, had to just force over her forehand, and it was not an easy shot. I think I'm throwing my lucid verdict here. Pretty happy with that shot right there.
I would assume Kat's probably throwing a hyzer with a mid or a putter even.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think it was a putter.
Probably PA2, I'm guessing.
Mm-hmm. That was unfortunate. It just hit the side of the hill a little bit on an angle, tried to skip up, but then just
and took
landed
off
on edge and went rolling. Yeah, that was heartbreaking.
She's taking the easy par.
Yep. Kat was surprised. She didn't actually notice that happened. I don't think many of us could tell either. And yeah, it's a bummer.
Yeah, it's right there. A little disappointing that it picked up and rolled, but it's an easy par from there.
Yeah, she's got a few strokes to waste, so...
She's not worrying about much.
I had a little moth on me, or butterfly, so told told him to go away for a second.
Yep, dead center.
Yeah, this definitely feels like a really good birdie to get. To land that green is just a really fun shot to hit perfectly.
That was a pretty easy birdie from Lisa.
Oh, yeah.
When you put it 6 feet away, it's kind of hard to miss it.
Hole 9, another par 5, 792 feet. You are just shooting straight uphill. And so the first objective is to just get basically to the top of the hill as far as you can.
Like, right where that tree is, I think, is a good landing spot.
Yeah.
For us.
Yeah, you can, sometimes you can play to the inside of that tree, but then it sort of makes the fairway a little tighter. There's really no danger off to the left other than some rougher, higher grass and little bushes, but I like to play the hyzer out to the left and then just sort of keep chipping my way up and throwing some bigger drives. But then there's this last little tree looking thing on the left of the screen right now, and it's just past that where the basket sits. So yeah, I think it's a pretty easy par 5, but you know, if you hit anything early, you never know what could happen.
It's hard to get up that hill and to actually have some distance on it. Like, Lisa threw a really good shot.
Yeah.
She threw a little turnover uphill and it got up there.
Yeah.
I've seen multiple people just go right over that bush and hit the ground.
Yeah. I early released it, so I landed a little bit in the rough on the left, but
You can just throw a big power shot and have a look at the basket for a par still.
Yeah.
Or even for birdie.
Kat was going big for sure. She was trying to Annie around that tree and then have some hyzer at the end, but it just kept Annieing. So she'll be underneath that tree, which isn't the worst, but definitely not what she was looking for. I'm trying to go big because I'm definitely shorter than I was the previous few rounds. I just turned it over a little bit too much and still in the middle of the fairway, just not quite as far as I wanted.
Kat's going big.
Yeah.
She clipped that branch?
Yeah, so this is like that inside route that I had mentioned. It does make it a bit of a tighter fairway. It does cut off the distance a little bit, but then you have to deal with those trees along the way. So, yeah, unfortunately she hit that next tree.
When I was on the right side, I didn't mess with that gap. I just threw a big forehand around it.
Lisa turned it over a little bit. She'll be on the right side, but, and Erica, I remember the shot. It's sort of tough. It, like, the hill goes up, and then you kind of want to keep it a little lower so that you don't hit those trees in the middle. But, yeah, you hate to see that.
Looks like she cracked it well and is just right in the middle.
Yep. Yeah, Kat was a little pinched here, couldn't run up, and she's just trying to play a placement shot at the moment.
Around that tree. Yep. She'll have a putt from there. It'll be a little jump putt, but yeah, Lisa looks like she got pinched off a little bit.
Yeah.
Still had a great upshot from there with that patent pending stance.
Yep, she'll have a long putt for her birdie.
Yep, Erica's just right outside circle one.
I'm trying to put it close. I'm still quite a ways out.
I'd say it's still like 300 from there.
Yeah.
If not a little more.
Yeah, and I threw a mid-range. I probably could have thrown something a little straighter. I will have a long putt for birdie.
Ooh, Kat's just a little bit low on her putt for birdie. You're probably like 45, 50?
Yeah, I think it was probably similar to that putt from a few holes ago. Just didn't have that downhill to help me get there.
Alright, so it's difficult with that upshot that you guys just had, was that you're going downhill, so you think you need to throw it. Ooh, great putt. You think you need to throw it softer, but you still need to throw it the same.
Yep.
That's a huge putt for me, so.
She was only, I mean, I think we were similar distances. So yeah, that was a great putt.
I think Lisa's always been like one of my favorite putters, just because when she's on, it's crazy. Like, I think she is the best putter in the world.
Yeah.
When she's on, it's crazy. And so are you. Your jump putts? I'm like, how?
It's sometimes it's just a feeling, you know?
Yeah.
People ask me all the time, and I'm just like, you just gotta feel it.
When you're feeling it?
It's probably annoying to hear that, because putting is really frustrating. But...
Yeah, for some people, it's very frustrating. Yep.
I'll take a par. I did, you know, I did get the birdie the last two rounds, so it feels a little bit like a lost stroke there, but...
It was a good par save, though.
Yeah.
I mean, off the tee, it was a little rough for you, but...
Yeah.
You made that easy par, though.
Yeah. So three of us putting for par, putting in for par, and Lisa got the birdie. So there's your top three at the moment after the front nine. I hope you enjoyed the front nine and that you will join us for the back nine. And we'll see you then.
Let's make a change.